Hello students, so how are you all? I will be teaching English for you to English, and today you are going to learn about a martyr who sacrificed his life for our country. Okay, so you know very well who are the people who are protecting our nation, our borders, our motherland. So it is none other than our soldiers. Okay, so the lesson you are going to learn today is a great martyr ever cherished. You know very well that India fought a war called as Kargil War in the year 1999. It was fought between India and Pakistan. Okay, it was between May to July in the year 1999. And it is also called as Operation Vijay, because the Indian operation was sent here to clear the Pakistanis from the Kargil sector. So it is also called as Kargil conflict in India. Okay, and we won the war, and it is and our soldiers were very victorious in this war. So we have the martyrs, we have the soldiers who sacrificed their lives in this war, and you can see this in the slide.
Uniform 143, hostile listening, over.
What you heard right behind you were the sound of Bofors guns directly targeting the top of Tiger Hills, the prelude to the final assault. Also going on simultaneously are multi-barrel rocket launchers, also attacking the same positions on Tiger Hills.
At the moment we are firing 2 of the 14, we can fire 14.
At the moment we are running for cover. We just had a shell land very close to us. I doubt if you were able to see anything. That was another shell.
Careful, careful.
Now we really are going into the bunker.
I just hope so, sir. Koi gir gaya to nothing is going to be left here.
Hello, listen, Shivnath, I'm calling from a bunker. I can't speak. Quickly take down the details.
This underway, sir.
We launched multi-barrel rocket launcher attack in addition to the direct firing by Bofors guns.
Yeah.
Oh my
yeah,
god.
Yeah.
Hello?
It's the pattern of firing which the Baki were firing. You can't hear any small arms. And our RT has also stopped. That means we've gone in. And whatever we're firing is going beyond the Tiger Hill. That means our troops are there on top.
300, 400 to Nino.
Cheers to Tiger and to the press.
After 11 hours of near continuous fighting and heavy exchange of fire, Tiger Hills finally looks like it belongs to India once again. And with this recovery, the Indian troops hope to regain control of the Dras sector almost immediately. It truly is the dawn of a new day. With Ajmal Jami, Barkhana.
So you can see their pictures. These were the soldiers who sacrificed their lives to protect our country. So Captain Vikram Batra, Major General Ian Cardoza, Second Lieutenant Arun Ketarpal, Nayak Jadu Nath Singh, Major Ramaswamy Parameshwaran, Brigadier Mohammed Usman, Surendra Yogendra Singh Yadav, Major Somnath Sharma and Subedar Karam Singh, and Lieutenant Rifleman Jaswant Singh. Okay, but we are going to Anif Uddin will be representing all of them in the lesson. So Anif, we are going to learn about Anif Uddin. We are going to learn about Anif Uddin and how he was inspired to join the Indian Army. Okay, so the lesson is a great martyr ever cherished. A great martyr ever cherished. Enter the Anif Uddin's household and a warm smile will beckon you to step right in. But that's all the smile can do as it beams from within the confines of a picture frame. A mere memory, painful and brave, the smile belongs to the 25-year-old martyr, Lieutenant Anif Uddin. As you take a deep breath and try to avert the pain that comes from knowing of a young life cut short, you will notice a large picture of snow-capped mountain peaks of the Turtic sector in Kargil, now called Subsector Anif, in memory of Anif Uddin's bravery. Okay? So, dear students, you know very well, if somebody dies in the house, in memory of them, we keep a photo of the person. Okay? So, the first paragraph explains that Anif photo was there in his house, and the soldiers, his friends, visited the house to give a condolence message to his family. Okay, and Anif died at the age of 25, a very young soldier. We'll go to the next paragraph. Perhaps Anif Uddin, or Khalifa as his friends called him, knew what he would be able to give to the nation, which probably explains why Anif Uddin, who hailed from a family of musicians, chose to join the army. Perhaps Anif Uddin also knew that life for him was short and so needed to repeatedly remind himself of his mission. One can only surmise from a flashcard found amongst his belongings, which simply said, "We change lives." Okay, so when his friends visited his house, they were expressing to his mother, maybe because his life is very short, so he chose to become a soldier and protect our country. Okay, and Anif's family is not a family who were in the defense force. They were all musicians. So they are assuming, maybe because his life is very short, he must have chosen to serve the nation. Fate had ensured that Anif Uddin would battle with hardships from a tender age. When he was just 8 years old, Anif lost his father, who had been an artist associated with the National School of Drama. Okay, so Anif's life was not on bed of roses. He had hardships. He had many difficulties in life. When he was very young, he lost his father, who was an artist in the National School of Drama. Left to take care of three young boys, Anif's mother, Hema Aziz, a local artist, would often have to leave Anif and his brothers alone as she travelled with the performance wing of the Information and Broadcasting Ministry. Okay, so Anif's mother, what was her work? Okay, she was an local artist, she was a singer. Okay, and where was she working? She was working in the Information and Broadcasting Ministry. So very often she used to leave Anif and his two brothers at home alone. Okay, because they didn't have father, and these children had to stay alone at home. Okay, so Hema Aziz recalls, she tells to Anif's friend, "I had a touring job and was out very often, and the kids became very responsible, getting up and getting ready for school without my having to tell them. I didn't have to tell them in so many words, but my going to work without excuses gave them the message that one's duty is the most important thing in life." So what kind of children Anif and his brothers were? They were very responsible children. How can we say they were very responsible children? His mother, Hema Aziz, says that when she never told children to be good or be responsible, she went to her work without any excuse. Looking at the mother, children learned that one's duty is very important in life. That's what she is expressing to Anif's friends. While Anif's elder brother, Nafis Uddin, went on to become a teacher and was at the J.D. Taylor School, New Delhi, at the time of the tragedy. His younger brother took to composing music on his Casio. Anif would often team up with him on the drums. Okay, so his elder brother, what was the work of his elder brother? His elder brother was a teacher, okay, in New Delhi, in J.D. Taylor School. And his brother, his younger brother also was very fond of music, and he used to play on the Casio. Anif, we'll go to the next paragraph. An introvert, Anif began to make friends only by the time he was 14 years of age. An introvert meaning is a person who is not very much outgoing, very quiet and silent. So only at the age of 14 he made friends, which means when he was very small, when he was first standard, second standard and all, he was all alone. Maybe from the standard 8 he started becoming friends to all. Okay, he would often go out of his way to help people because that gave him a certain kind of joy. In fact, this was the quality seniors recounted when they came to meet me after his death, explains his mother. Okay, so his nature, Anif's nature, what was Anif's quality? He loved to help people. That is what his seniors told his mother. So when he helped people, he was very happy. He felt a sense of joy in helping people. And he was able to reach out to all. Hema mentions that a 77-year-old gentleman who paid a condolence visit to Anifuddin's house recalled how Anif had approached him with some queries related to Sufism. Okay, so Hema Aziz, his mother, also says that he had a 77-year-old friend who was just 25. Anif was just 25 and he had a friend who was 77 years old. So what was the discussion between 77-year-old friend and Anif? They were talking about Sufism. Okay, Sufism is a branch in Islamic religion where the truth of divine love they want to experience through direct, they want to have a personal experience of God. So where did Anif study? We will come to know now. Anif was a student of Kerala School in New Delhi and had applied to the army when he was graduating from Shivaji College, New Delhi. Yet Anif didn't know much about the army. The only exposure my sons had was through me, as I often gone to the forward areas on performance for the Armed Forces Entertainment Wing. Okay, so Anif studied in Kerala School in New Delhi. And how did he join the army? Hema Aziz used to go to the performance wing in the entertainment wing in the army. And along with his mother, he used to go to give some shows there. However, 6 months into the Indian Military Academy training, the gentle Anif was a changed man. During those days, he used to write to me about how tough the training was. I particularly remember him telling me that they had to take a Muzuri bath at midnight. I suppose it was some kind of cold water bath at midnight, remembers Hema. Okay, so when he joined the Indian Military Academy training, Anif used to write letters to his mother explaining how tough the training was in the army, and he had expressed saying that they had to take a Muzuri bath in midnight. Okay, Muzuri bath here is a cold water bath, that too in the Himalayan hill station. Okay, so you know very well how in Himalayas are covered with snow, and taking cold water bath at midnight in Muzuri. Okay, so we know very well from this line that how tough the training is in the defense force. Post training, Anif joined the 11 Rajputana Rifles and was posted at Jaipur and then at Siachen just prior to the Kargil War of 1999. After receiving the training, he joined the 11 11 Rajputana rifles at Jaipur, and after that he was posted at Siachen before the Kargil war. Yet life for Anif was always ekdam bindas. Okay, his friends tell that his life was ekdam bindas. That means he was busy and also he was very good at doing things. Whatever he did it to his best. He dabbled in art, sketched very well, made beautiful cards out of waste material, read a great deal and loved playing the drums. So these were his other, hobbies. Okay, so what did he do? He dabbled in art. He was very good at drawing. He sketched very well. He did beautiful cards with waste materials. Okay, and he was also very good at playing drums, which is why the officers at the Raj Riffs made him get all the instruments from Delhi and formed the music group now called Anif. Okay, so they made a music group and that music group was called as Anif. While there was not enough time to rise up the ranks as he had dreamed, another of Anif's wishes did come true when the subsector was named after him. As a young officer, Anif had once told his mother how a post, the Nana Singh post, had been named after a brave soldier. Anif had expressed about a soldier where he told that Nana Singh, a soldier, died in one of the wars and a post was named after that soldier who died, Nana Singh. So that was one of his dream. Okay, he was expressing his dream. So his bravery does live on in the air of the coal mountains and on the plains. A scholarship now exists in the name and his family has started a school in Kullu under the Anif Foundation. So, okay, so his family, his mother has started a school under Anif Foundation and it is named as Anif Foundation. Despite the pain and loss, Anif has earned his family a glory that will see them through the years. It is the pride that has made Hema Aziz politely decline the Indian Army's compensation offer of a petrol pump. Okay, so here the mother is making a great sacrifice. Now when soldiers die, the government gives them compensation. So what compensation the family offered to Anif was a petrol pump. But the mother said no, they don't want the petrol pump. Why? Because she says these words: there are so many families whose sole bread earner is gone. They need it more, says this mother of a martyr. So she says, maybe you can use this petrol pump to another soldier who is the only breadwinner of the family. And she refuses to take that offer and she offers it to the other families. So this is also a great deed of Anifuddin's mother. Okay, so thank you very much. I hope you understood the lesson.